Hi everyone, it's Roseanne, and I am going to do a tutorial really quickly on something I've been working on. I was trying to find new ways to make some butterflies, and this is what I came up with. Isn't that cute? It's a lace butterfly, and well, let me explain this one. I just have two stick pins for the stamens, and then some bling from my stash, some pearl bling there. And then this one, this is the first one I made. This one, also made out of lace, but I beaded some seed beads on some wire. And I think that wire is 26 gauge wire. And I got this, I don't even know where I got this from. I think at a yard sale or something, but it's just plain wire. And then I put a purple feather in there and some bling in the four corners and some bling in the center. And they look really pretty and, you know, very dainty. And I guess if you used more pinks and lighter blues and stuff, it could really be very, like this one, could be very, very shabby chic, which is all the rage right now. I also did playing around with flowers, and look at this. Isn't that pretty? And I will do an upcoming tutorial on this one, but this is done with the skeleton leaves. And this is some of the skeleton leaves that Chris gave me. Hi Chris. So I'll do a tutorial later on how to make a rose with the skeleton leaves. Okay, so now that I've talked your ears off, let's get started. I bought some of this big wide lace from Zenderly, and it's pretty big. It's about as big as my hand, as you can see. And what I figured out making these is, if you could do a piece of lace that is, I don't know, 6x6 or 5x5 square, then that's gonna make about this size. This one's gonna be 6x6 because that's how big this lace is. It's actually 6.5 or so. So what I'm gonna do is just cut a square of this lace. You can use any lace. Just depends on how big you want your butterfly to be. And so I have a square of lace. And then what I'm gonna do is just fold it in half and fold it in half again, and then I'm going to cut those halves so that I have four squares. And now these squares are going to be like 3.5 by 3.5 squares. And then really simply what you're going to do is, see this pattern? This has a pattern, and then this has a different pattern. I'm going to use one of each so that I can put a little interest in the butterfly. And all you need to do is get a piece of thread and a needle, tie a knot, and you're going to go corner to corner. So you're going to do the running stitch, really simple, in and out, really quick running stitch from corner to corner diagonally. Very good. See, it's already, you can see the wing, and pull it through. And then you're going to do the other one. Again, corner to corner. And that's the reason for the square. I've done these butterflies also with ovals and with circles. And with ovals, you're going to go on the skinny side, and with circles, you're going to go down the middle. Okay, so see, there's your butterfly already. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tighten up this thread and just make a really quick knot so we can hold this all together here. Okay. Almost done here. Okay, there we go. And then I'm gonna cut that and put a knot in it right away. That way it's ready for the next time. Okay, and I'm gonna stick it over here so I don't lose it, because I stepped on a needle once when I was in California and I was trying to get my craft room all set up. And I was going through some boxes and I found a needle in a box and I was sitting on the floor and got up to do something. I had stuck the needle in the floor and said, "I'm not gonna forget that that needle is there." What did I do? I forgot. So I got up to go put something away, and when I came back to sit down in my place, I jabbed the needle in my toe. It was not fun. Okay, so see, there's your butterfly. Isn't that gorgeous? And it just depends on the lace, the style of lace. But now all you really need to do is, find your trim. This trim I used, let me see, I got a bunch of bits here. I used some leftover trim that I had. I mean, I've got like stuff like this, little bits and pieces that I use. You can find really whatever you want. Do a really pretty feather. Stick a feather in there. You can use stamens. You can use roses. Like these roses, take them off of the wire and stick a rose in there. Or do three roses, which I think that's what I'm going to do to this one, is I'm going to do three roses. You can use some of this bling. Actually, maybe I'll do some bling too. So anyway, I'm gonna grab my trusty fabric tack. A lot of you ladies maybe can't get this fabric tack. I get this at Joann's. If you can order from Joann's online, then you'll be able to get it. So I'm just going to put glue in the center here. Just a little bit. And I like using this glue because it dries really fast. But a lot of you ladies probably, can use your glue gun or your other favorite type of glue. And see, I'm just pulling it so that I can make sure this is straight, because it tends to want to go crooked for some reason. I don't know why that is. So I'm just going to make sure this goes down the center. There we go. Really pretty. And then let me see, I have some wire already beaded. How much time do I have? All you ladies know how to bead wire, right? Let's do that. I got everything out here. Let me move all this stuff out of the way. Okay, let's grab some wire. And you only need about 6 inches or so. And I like to just use my pointy scissors and just wrap, make a little circle there. so that your beads don't fall out this end. I'm just using regular seed beads. I've got a bunch here, different colors all mixed together. And I'm just gonna, because you've got a wire, I mean, you just need to stick the wire in there, and it gets threaded really fast when you use wire, really easy. As I get older, it's getting harder and harder to see all these little holes and threading needles and stuff. So see, you just keep pushing your wire through. And beading your wire. It goes really fast. You can bead wire, get a big long strip of wire and just bead a bunch while you're watching TV or something. And you really don't even have to look what you're doing. Oops. Really don't have to watch what you're doing. You can just bead the wire while you watch TV. Okay, now come on, little beads. Okay, so there we go. That's going to be good enough. So now all I'm going to do is just grab this end, and maybe it's too long. Let me cut a little bit off. Okay, grab this end and then just twist the wire on this end so your beads don't fall out. And there you got your little antenna. And with this one, because I already put this in the center, I'm just gonna attach it to the back. So put my little fabric tack back there. And you can adjust it however long you want them. And there's your little butterfly. Isn't that cute? Came out really good. Okay, ladies. There you go. You can put bling or glitter, whatever you want to put on here. You can layer up, you know, make a smaller square, and then put another butterfly in there. Where's my butterfly? This guy. Just put two layers. Look at how pretty that would look with two layers. And then just sew them together. So, possibilities are endless. Anyway, I hope you like my butterflies. I hope you try them. They're really fun and really quick to make. And thanks for watching. And I'll see you all next time. Bye.